Damien, welcome.
Jared.
How are you, mate? Tomo.
He's playing, isn't he?
Have you muted yourself on purpose,
Damien? I'm only joking, brother. It's all right. I can't answer that.
You smart ass, you are.
Well, we were probably more of the opinion that the ratings are a bit down, so they got the two funny guys on there to try and boost us up. So.
Every Richmond player should understand that Dimmer used to try and sneak out of the meetings on the side door.
Bloody hell, when you knew every answer, there was no point being there.
I've copped a fair bit of flack, I reckon, for the medical marijuana. The players reckon they're doing cones in the box upstairs half the time.
Just look at him.
And Damien, we'll leave you to the Bob Marley soundtrack on the way home.
Wind down your windows.
Leave them up, better effect.
He's always been good for a laugh on the 360 agenda. Damien Hardwick bows out with a trademark sense of humour and emotion, happy to walk away from his true love, knowing he had nothing more to give. Amid a deep sense of shock, a wave of gratitude from the Tiger Army engulfs Punt Road as the legacy of the Hardwick years and its three premierships is weighed. And no man played more games under Dimmer than Jack Revolts. We'll go inside the events of the past 48 hours as an era ends for the Tigers. I'm Jared Wadley, here's Mark Robinson. This Tuesday night, it's Footy from All Angles. Robbo, hello.
Hello, Jared.
It's no less stunning tonight than it was 24 hours ago that the Hardwick years are finished at Richmond.
Richmond Football Club. 13 years and 10 games. Three flags. Left another one on the table, maybe. Yeah, it's still quite a shock. But when he walked out that door, when he did the press conference today, and whatever that in-joke was, good on him. That was as good a departing press conference I've heard in my time in football.
It was abrupt. There was a finality to it, as you point out. He left his press conference and headed straight down to the car, sort of never to be seen again, in a way.
Yeah, it did. And it was really nice to see his family there. And, look at him in the car driving.
From the moment we saw the visual that he was in civvies rather than the club, So this is done.
When I was thinking about it today, Jared, and I don't want to go too deep here, I thought to myself, what a void he has now in his life. He spoke at length about the love of the club and the love of the people, and every day he walked in and he saw the people and their smiling faces, and that's not going to be there. So he's got a lot of life to fill, because the Richmond coaching job, any coaching job, is, 6 hours a day. So it'll be interesting to see what happens in the future with Damien.
All right, here's how we have it set up tonight. AFL 360, thanks to NIB. All of the fallout from today's announcement. Jack Revolt, so looking forward to that conversation. Jeremy Howe with his great mate Steel Sidebottom reaching 300 games for the Pies. We'll meet Josh Weddle, who is the Hawk rising star. And Cam Mooney, I don't know whether you saw today's weigh-in.
I did, actually. Oh, I saw a photo of it.
What is he doing? 24 kilos less than Tom Bell Chambers.
But I think he thinks he can handle himself.
And then tomorrow, Zach Tui is going to join us. We'll have the watch lists, Jordan Lewis and Brad Johnson together, and David Rhys-Jones is going to be here to
play.
It's
a big night. Wednesday's becoming monsters, aren't they?
They really are. Shall we?
Yes, let's get into it.
The agenda belongs to Richmond's longest-serving coach, Damien Hardwick. The end was as stunning as it was shocking. It's given pause for reflection of a glorious era that redefined an AFL powerhouse.
Ladies and gentlemen, would you now please welcome to the podium the coach of the 2017 Toyota AFL Premiership team, Damien Hardwick.
Been fortunate enough to be in a lot of footy clubs, but
By far, the Richmond Football Club's been the love of my life. So I thank you from the bottom of my heart. I couldn't have wished a better place to have my journey as an AFL coach, and the support I've received from not only the Richmond Football Club full stop, but the fans and our players, obviously, that was one of the more tougher conversations that I've had to do. You know, the way this club supported me, gave me every resource possible, gave me the best people possible. It's a testament to what I think we've created. It became apparent, you know, probably 2 weeks ago that the time was about right. And the club means so much to me, and I want to make sure that I leave the game loving the game, not resenting the game. But also I want to make sure that I leave this place just with the best feelings. I came here seeking silverware, but the reality is I walk away thinking how great the journey was.
Not surprised the decision. Upon reflection, but you know, we were committed to working through it, but you know, Damien said the tank's empty.
And I'm just sitting here with tears running down my face. I feel very emotional, and just I'd like to say thanks, Dimmer, for everything you've done for the Tigers and all the joy you've given all the Tiger supporters, and all the best for the future, mate. We all love you.
To the Tiger Army.
Changed the game in a lot of ways. I'm so fortunate for my time at Richmond and grateful to have worked with him. He's an incredible coach.
What an outstanding coach. He's one where I've definitely been inspired by what he's done.
Yeah, he allowed us to have fun again, like come into the footy pub and that's the place that he's created, that we want to show up every day and see each other, and we always leave the smile on our face, win, lose or draw. And yeah, I've been so lucky to have Dimmer out.
It's been a long career that he's had in footy now. You look at, you know, what he did as a player and then how many clubs he's coached at before he arrived at us. It's a phenomenal career in footy, so I think he's earned his rest for sure.
From the bottom of my heart, boys, I wish you all the very best. I'm going to miss you. As always, I love you to death and all the people that have supported me and been part of my journey. I thank you, I applaud you, and I wish you all the very best for future endeavours. And Alumi.
It's hard not to feel emotional watching that.
Yeah, it was. When he nearly broke down today, he's a hard-ass Dimmer, and he almost broke down. He was talking about his love for the players. An hour earlier, he was bawling his eyes out in the grown Richmond room at Punt Road as he spoke to the players. He wasn't alone. We'll talk to Jack about that.
Yeah.
He was in that meeting. But as I said, it was one of the best, you know, leaving coaching press conferences. The thing that really hit home for me, Jared, is when he said, you know, I want to leave this football club with the best feeling. And I thought, you are so lucky. Because most coaches get sacked. And he's leaving on his terms, on his will, and everyone goes, hey, thanks. Thanks for everything you've done for our footy club. So, yeah, well done to Richmond and well done to Damien Hunt.
The abrupt nature of it is actually, it's a great way to go in a way, isn't it? So he conveyed that he knew coming into this season that would be his last, but he kept that close. The board acknowledged that it was shocked, and Brendan Gale obviously imparted that he didn't see it coming, but in hindsight he could read the signs a little bit better. But he didn't know on Sunday when Damien Hardwick dropped round for a beer and a chat that that's what it was going to be.
He didn't try and talk him out of it.
No.
He sat there and listened to Damien Hardwick, and he realised, and people were telling me this today, Brendan realised this guy's done, he's cooked, so there's no, come on, what do you think, you know? No, it's all over. It's hard to say this at the moment, but in time, he will absolutely be listed as an icon of not just Richmond, but of the AFL. He's won five flags, Jared.
Yeah, so this is the legacy piece, isn't it?
Yeah, it's five flags. One each at Essendon and Port Adelaide, and three as a coach at Richmond. And we'll get on to his future in a second. I'm sure it's not the end of Damien Hardwick. But that's a hell of a CV.
Reignited the club, changed coaching, so left his imprint on the profession. And then the third element was what he did to the game. So
He made chaos rule, didn't he? He made chaos beautiful, desired, and in the end, essential. You had to be playing that way.
Yeah, we were playing keepings off there for a little while in football and we were wondering where it was going, and Hawthorn won three flags and the Bulldogs come along and disrupted that. And then the Dogs come along and introduced this surge football. Remember when Jack had all the smalls around him and it was like a... Right, it was a necessity, but it was great coaching on the run. He introduced vulnerability. Now, people say, no, we've been talking about vulnerability for years. He introduced vulnerability at Richmond and it brought a playing group together really, really tight knit.
Their juggernaut was built on that off-field connection far more than the X's and the O's.
Yeah, absolutely. They changed at the end of 2016 when he went on his trip, I think, to Harvard University and came back with a renewed philosophy.
So that's the legacy at Punt Road. Is the last dance aspect to it was really interesting.
Yeah, it was.
So it is exactly as it appeared. Is while Revolt and Cochin were still there, he was inspired to have one last snatch at it to see if it was possible. Added pieces. It was a bit of a luck tester coming into the season, and then he progressively realised that it wasn't going to be.
It's hard not to be seduced by The Last Dance. I don't know how many times you've watched it, Jared. I've watched it about three times. I really have. I just keep picking it up and watching it. And people in football, a lot of commentators, and I'm not pointing the finger at anyone, it's just a collective, they say, you went too far. But if you've got a chance at winning a premiership, you've got to go for it. They're hard to win. It's hard to get yourself in a position to win. And when you think you're there, you've got to go for it. And I don't want people to say, oh, nah, they stuffed it up, you know, it's gone, they didn't never had a chance. You've got to give yourself a chance. Anyway, it's not working. They've got three wins from 10 games. They're probably not going to play finals. If they won the premiership from here, you're talking about one of the great stories in the history of footy. But
this has clearly been percolating in his mind for a while. You won't recall this, but as soon as I show it to you, you'll remember. So this is 12 months ago. This is mid-May last year.
Would you entertain a different role at another club, or are you a Tiger man through and through now?
Well, it's hard. I'm a Tiger man through and through now. But at the end of the day, my time will come. There's no question about that. I've got a group of players and, you know, for example, we've probably got a list that we think can, you know, continue to challenge. And then when that challenge point finishes, it's probably when Damien Hardwick walks away, when someone else takes the reins. I think we're regenerating now. We've got some talent coming through that we're very, very excited about. We've got some players that are more towards the end than the beginning of their careers. Yeah. And it's just finding that right template to get the best result for both parties coming, leaving and coming.
Another club, question mark?
Wait and see.
It's not a no.
I should have said no.
No, you didn't say that.
It's not a no, but when the challenge point
12 months ago,
finishes,
that question, Jared.
Yeah, it's 12 months in the making.
Too early.
And the challenge point revealed itself to be finished. His coaching future, so he very neatly sidestepped...
He made a joke.
Himself to
he
a position,
made a joke.
So he wants to decompress and take a break now. Didn't define how long he needed a break. Didn't present as a broken figure who was worn out at all.
No, he
didn't.
Was
very specific to he's gone as his sausage analogy, so yabby genius.
That was the best. That was the best.
Cook sausages 1,000 ways, just couldn't think of 1,001 ways to do it and felt this group needed a new voice. Premiership player at Essendon, premiership player at Port Adelaide, premiership coach at Richmond. He is a free spirit. So he says he's a Richmond man. Mm. It's easy to see him at another club when he's ready.
He had the opportunity last year and he had the opportunity this year, today, to say no, I'm done. But he's not done and he knows he's not done. He'll go away and then he'll be offered a challenge. Now, where that challenge will be, that's the interesting bit. I absolutely don't think there's any chance that Damien Hardwick will be coaching Port Adelaide next year. Zero chance. Even if Richmond went to Ken Inkley and said, Ken, we'll give you 5 years, Ken will say no. He's invested so much in these young people at Port Adelaide.
As long as Port offer him a contract.
But we've said it a couple of times. How ridiculous is it that they wouldn't offer him a contract? He's a great coach, Ken Inkley. So Ken won't be coaching Richmond. So the net's wide. Where Damien Hardwick ends up, I feel a little bit sorry for Stuart Gill. I know. Did you know?
The most striking aspect of what we played you at the start, and it only occurred to me as we were watching it, is Stuart Gill is Damien Hardwick's running mate. Our coaches largely choose their partners who they're going to come on the show with. And in all of those clips, Damien Hardwick is alongside Stuart Gill by choice.
Right. Premiership teammates in 2004. I found out today that Damien Hardwick, and I presume Stuart Gill, but certainly Damien Hardwick, he's in the Port Adelaide Premiership WhatsApp group. And every Thursday before the grand final, even when Demmer was coaching the teams in the grand final, Demmer would go for a drink with his Port Adelaide teammates, right, on the Thursday night of grand final week. Now, I don't think that when Alistair Clarkson was being thrown, his name was being thrown about Gold Coast, he wasn't going to go there because Stuart Gill, he coached Stuart Gill. Stuart Gill helped Clarkson win a premiership. He's not going to be a part of any machinations to get rid of Stuart Gill. I would feel that Damien Hardwick would feel the same about his great mate Stuart Gill. So, unless the AFL moves on Gill, maybe then Hardwick may be interested, but he's not going to be making any moves against Gold Coast.
You'd think they would have to be so far separate and removed.
Yep. And I'm only jumping the gun talking about Stuart Gill. I don't like that situation.
Yeah. All right, should we bring Jack in?
Why not? It's Jack's night.
There's a special bond between player and coach, and it's as tight with Jack, who lived the whole journey with him, as with anyone.
I wanted to create an environment where the players would walk in with a smile and regardless of outcome would walk out with one. And I hope I've achieved that. And some of it was through, you know, the ability for me to, you know, make my energy, you know, and the players to feed off that. And some of it was from my bad jokes. Speaking to some of the players and, you know, Dustin suggested I go to Ibiza and and Bakes suggested I go to Lake Grace. So it's somewhere in between where I'll find myself. One last story probably before I go is I rang the great Jack Riewoldt and I sort of said, oh, mate, are you available to catch up? And, of course, Jack made it all about him. He thought I was going to talk, but I said, no, mate, this isn't about you for once in your life sort of thing. So he'll be deeply embarrassed about that, but it just sums up Jack, to be fair.
Guilty or not guilty, Jack Riewoldt, welcome.
Hello, boys. How are we?
Good, good.
Yeah, I've been thrown under the bus there. One last time he's thrown me under. Getting to the end of your career, boys, and obviously I've had one rough game on the weekend. I'm getting a bit older and I get a text from him. He goes, hey, mate, are you free to catch up today?
Ooh.
And I've just gone, oh, no. I'm getting wound up here. And then I said, I had something on which I couldn't get out. I said, I can't, but are you free to chat on the phone now? And he called me and I said to him, I was half expecting this text a little bit. And then he goes, it's not about you, mate, it's about me. And I was like, oh, and then he said what he said. And I was like, oh no. So obviously a big day at Tigerland today. It's been a big 48 hours, been an emotional 48 hours for a lot of people, players, staff, certainly fans as well on social media. And I mean, this man has changed the lives of not only the people inside of the club, but changed the lives of the Richmond faithful that have been starved for premiership success for 37 years.
What did he say to you and how did you react?
He just said pretty much what he'd said today, that he'd sort of come to the end of his journey at Richmond. I've cooked sausages 1,000 times. I can't find the 1,000th and one time to cook them. And that he felt this group was still in a really good position but just needed a new voice, and that voice wasn't his.
Can you take us inside before the press conference, who were in the Grand Richmond room, staff and not all staff, but senior staff and the players? I've been told there was a few tears in that room. It was quite an emotional speech. Can you take us into that room, please?
It's very emotional because there's more than an element, there's that sadness of the person that has been tasked with the job of inspiring you, leading you, driving you
and succeeding
to the ultimate success and guiding you through that is not going to be at that football club when we walk in the door tomorrow and start to prepare for for this weekend's game. There's probably a pit in your stomach where you're sort of like, oh, that journey and that era is over, which is really sad. There's only two players at the football club that have played for Richmond and have been coached by another coach other than Damien. That's myself and Trent. Everyone else has spent their whole journey under him as a father figure, which most senior men coaches take on, because you go and pluck kids from all over Australia, from different backgrounds, and they sort of yearn to attach themselves to the senior coach, the person that provides them with their opportunity to achieve their goals, whether that's getting one game, getting 100 games, or winning a premiership, which we've been lucky to do, that there is always an element of sadness with that.
Can I just draw your attention to this? So I'm not sure whether you've seen this. Josh Kay popped this up late in the day. You and Damien Hardwick are second all-time in the combination of games between player and coach, behind only Gordon Coventry and Jock McHale, which belongs to a totally different era, and in front of Bill Hutchison and Dick Reynolds. So your link is historically significant, the 289 games.
Yeah, it's... it's a bond and a relationship which I don't think you can... You can't make up in a short period of time. I mean, there's been so many ebbs and flows in mine and Dimmer's relationship. You think back to sort of early 2010s when he wanted to boot me up the bum for a few missed time comments.
For what exactly? Can you list them all?
Can't remember, to be honest. But at some of my lowest points when I've been performing really poorly, he's welcomed me into his house on a Tuesday, Wednesday night and said, right, let's have three beers each and let's just figure this out. What's going on? And that's really special as a mentor and as a coach, to look outside of, you're looking after 45 players plus the whole club, to then just single one person out to try and get a response from them.
So you more than anyone saw the transitioning coaching philosophy from Hardwick and from the... over the 2016 to the start of the 2017 pre-season, which is when he introduced the HHH, and you spoke about it on grand final day when you made the grand final. How much did that change, the change you saw in how Hardwick coached?
I think 2017 we developed this intangible bond that gave us strength on the field, which you couldn't actually quantify it. It wasn't, oh, that's a pressure rating of over two is great.
There
was this special bond that we developed through the 2017 pre-season that has lasted for a long time. Because there's so many guys in that era that went on to play 19 and 20 as well, that there is a really special bond there. And he was the provider of that bond with, I suppose that is probably the infamous education piece we used, was the Triple H, the Hero, Hardship and Highlight. And we found what our secret key was to unlocking success.
Whatever it is, it'll work.
Yeah, and it doesn't work. It doesn't work for everyone. And that's the search for any sporting team, I suppose, is what's the intangible that you can bring as a group that will connect you? Because fundamentally, when you go and pluck people from different backgrounds, different upbringings, from like different races and from different countries and all around Australia as well, that you have to find something that connects them. And still, even over a range now, like I'm 34 and we've got kids that are 18, how do you connect them? It's a really difficult thing to do, and we were able to do that.
So if you were to distill it, yours is going to be a Hall of Fame career, and it's been guided by this coach for the most part. How significant a figure in your life has Damien Hardwick been?
Oh, he's been the most important figure in my football career. And I think, I'm probably speaking on behalf of Trent and Dustin that have been there as well, and Dylan, the four players that have been there from the start, he would certainly be the most important figure in all of our careers. The impact that he's had from a tactical point of view and just from a teaching point of view, but then from a caring point of view as well, and a nurturing point of view, and life lessons as well. So he's it's not always been, we haven't been mollycoddled and we're told we're great and you're really good players, you just need to fix this. There's been some hard truths, and there's been we've got the cane out of those a few times and sort of just whipped us a little bit and said, hey, what's going on here? So there's certainly that aspect of it as well. And, yeah, it's a huge impact. And we wouldn't be the players we are today without him. And Richmond wouldn't be the club it is today without him.
One last one before we get. Is there a sense, what's greater today, the sense of pride or the sense of sadness?
The sense of pride, certainly. And that's last night. There was probably a select group of players that knew earlier yesterday morning that this was happening. And then you start to, you feel a whole range of emotions and everyone feels different emotions as well. But the thing that's come out of it is actually celebrating what a great Richmond man Dimmer is. And how he's been able to create great Richmond men under him as well. I mean, that's the sole purpose of a coach is to make your players better. Now, success can come if you've got to have a whole host of things line up. Sometimes it falls your way, sometimes it doesn't. But fundamentally, you just want to make your people better, and he's certainly done that.
Are you at all... Do you have any sense of lament that he won't coach you on Sunday when you'll know that it would have been for the last time?
Oh, look, I think that would be nice. And the fans probably want that opportunity to thank him. There will be a moment down the journey that we get to say thank you publicly in front of the Tiger Army to Dimmer. But there's an exciting new chapter that starts now. And this is a really interesting period for the football club. There's guys like myself that are coming to the end. The person that's led us through the successful period has now left. And this really breeds excitement for the next generation. And that all starts tomorrow when we walk in and we're led by Andrew McWalter.
We'll keep our conversation going and bring Jeremy Howe in as well, who's experienced a fair bit in footy. It is quite the day. It's a legendary day, really, in the history of the Richmond Football Club. We knew it would be from the time we sat here last night. Damien Hardwick, what a day, what a leader he's been. What a shock this has proven to be.